Ako po si Ethan Salvador.
When's your birthday?
My birthday is August 3rd. I'm a Leo.
Okay.
Yeah.
And, well, no,
sorry. My life motto, live by choice and not by chance. Everything in life is up to you, completely up to you. I love working out. I'm an adrenaline junkie, mm-hmm. So I love doing like parkour and like I want to skydive and do all that kind of stuff. A lot of my friends back in the States are into driving, so driving their sports cars and like just going
fast.
Super fast. Salvador is a person that's been through a lot, and a lot has changed in the last couple of years. I want to be remembered as someone who was able to inspire a lot of people. I want to be that guy that people, you know, thank for changing their mindset. Because the way people think sometimes is like, you know, different from what most people would want to think about life, if that makes sense. I'm very deep when it comes to life, and I like lifestyle choices and self-development, and I kind of want to push that with like my audience and fans here.
You see yourself as a positive person.
Mm-hmm. A lot of inspirations, but I mean, one of them is my mother, of course. I mean, she raised me as a single mom. And she instilled all my values and morals, and she made me who I am today. I read a lot of books. My top three idols from Hollywood, though, that really pushed me to like do this was Tom Hanks, you know, DiCaprio, and Johnny Depp. Not personally, but all like
yeah, their work.
The way I like to think about it is like I didn't really learn what to do. I've more learned like what not to do and how not to treat women, because my mother's been through a lot of heartbreaks. I was raised with my cousins who are Malay, and like seeing their boyfriends and how they were treated and how my father wasn't there. I just always kind of vowed like I wouldn't do the things that my father did because of how affected my mom was and my god sister. If that makes sense. I just wanted to be like that. An actual example of what a man should be. It happened after my second longest relationship. It was very manipulative. She had me thinking that I wasn't good enough. This is during the middle of my high school.
Mm-hmm.
So after we broke up, I fell into this deep depression. I didn't know what I was doing with my life because she made me like, am I really worth it? Like, are my choices correct? Am I really not enough for this person? And that's one of the biggest lessons that I, you know, learned was like never to change for other people, but just to like don't change to accept, be accepted by other people. Just do what you gotta do. They always say the only way out is through. So, I mean, when it comes to like negative experiences, you have to write it. That'll always have like something to look forward to, and I think that's what kept me strong through that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, I know I'm gonna get through this. I know the Lord is there and He guides us all. And I read a lot of self-help books at that time, and I had a lot of time alone. So, yeah.
Okay.
And my mom.